Okay, I will introduce myself. My name is Frank Vater. I'm working in IHP. Yeah, maybe I just go through my slides. There are some details about IHP. I'm the project leader in the PDK team, and that's even the reason why I'd like to talk about our SG13G2 technology, because we will provide an open source PDK for this technology. At first, small introduction to IHP. Ah, okay, I can see you. Then I go to the technology itself and the historic of the IHP open source PDK. I'm talking about our workshop that we had in June. I will give some technical details, a summary, and finally the acknowledgement. Some words about IHP. On the right side, you will see a picture about our building. Directly in the front, you see our clean room facilities. So we have our own fab. We are a research institute in Germany, located near Berlin, and we have many possibilities. We have stuff for material research. We have a technology department, which even drives the clean room. We have system department, where there are set up complete processors like RISC-V processors and all the other stuff. And we are involved into many funded and research project inside of Germany and in the EU. Our profile. What is very nice in IHP, we have this vertical research concept. So it means, as I said, from material up to system department, everything is available in IHP. And we are an international leadership in all research areas, especially in the BiCMOS technology. And our unique selling point is, as I said, our own fab with a 200 millimeter pilot line for the BiCMOS technology. And this operates 24 hours, 7 days a week. And we are offering qualified technology platforms in 0.13 technology and quarter micron technology for science and for industry. And even I will go to this point later in my talk. As example of this vertical value chain, you see on the left side one bipolar transistor in our technology. That transistor can be used in circuit design. We have a circuit design department, so they can build up an ASIC. In that case, you see an ASIC on the top. There's some analog stuff, and at the bottom, you can clearly see the stripes. Here some digital components are placed. Then it goes directly into production, maybe only single pieces if you like to test the device only, or if you have to build some, I would say, low volume products, you can even order a small series, and then it can be set up or built into customer projects. In that case, you see some measurement equipment, and I'm very proud that I can tell you that our products are built into the devices from Rohde & Schwarz. This is a very famous company for measurement equipment in Germany. And finally, for example, mobile phones are measured with equipment from IHP. Motivation for IHP is that we offer an open source PDK. Basically, IHP is a public funded institute, and we made a commitment for publishing all our research results, for example, even for papers that are available via open access. And we want to provide access to our technology and PDKs and design tools so that everyone can use our technology even for academic projects. We want to promote and support education, for example, in universities. in the past, it is, was necessary that students has to sign an NDA to create own devices, own chips, because of the fabs only offers PDKs under NDA. And in case that you have an open source PDK, it's pretty easy. Just download this and together with the tools, and you can start with education. Even we like to support startup companies because they are saving the license costs, for example, for the very expensive tools. And even they can use open source IP cores like RISC-V, OpenMSP 430, and all the stuff what is available, for example, on open cores. IHP offers low volume production. So as I said in the first example, if you like to sell some units, it might be possible to order devices in IHP. And furthermore, we like to offer the PDK as for pipe cleaning to demonstrate the possibilities and for the open source approach and the tools itself. Some words about our technologies. In IHP, we have different technologies. You can see the table. We have the SG13S technology, G2, and even G3 technology. And on the right side, you see an example about the F properties of the bipolar transistors. And even at the bottom, there's a TEM micro photography of our processor in G2 and G3 technology. I know most of you are digital guys and girls, I think, so analog stuff is not your main business, but in case, for example, you have a mobile phone, clearly you have to have some analog stuff for the radio front end and so on. Finally, we have chosen the G2 technology to make this available to customers as open source technology. Why is this? Even I will explain later. Some details about the technology itself. As I said, it's useful for analog, but even for digital applications. The bipolar transistors are very fast. We have frequencies for transit frequency of 350 gigahertz, and Fmax is 450 gigahertz. With that, we are in the leading of the in the world. Yeah, we have MOS transistors for low voltage and high voltage, so with that we have our own digital library, varectors based on MOS, different resistors and diodes, ESD diodes, and if you take a look onto the picture on the right side, you see at the very bottom is the front end, so it means the transistors, and on top of this are the different metal layers, this is metal 1, metal 2, and so on. And yeah, even we have type of MIM capacitor. It's placed somewhere here, so it's a small capacitor between as part of the metal stack. Yeah, inductors you can build in. One important point that we found out that from time to time there's a misunderstanding that I want to clarify this here. Open source PDK means it's not an open technology. We have chosen this technology because this technology is stable and qualified. So you can use the PDK, it's open source, but what we cannot do, we cannot adapt the technology. So it means everything in our fab is stable and so it is fixed. Some customers asking, oh, can we change the metal layers? Can we add or can we remove something? Unfortunately not. But nevertheless, it has the advantage that with the qualified technology, if you are building products or even some research project, if you follow the rules, then you can be sure that the device will have the estimated lifetime, maybe 10 years or 20 years or whatever you designed. So, history of open source PDK. Maybe it sounds a little bit strange because history, In last summer, we on ESIC in Paris, we announced that we will offer our SG13G2 technology as open source PDK. And basically, we started to choose the license model. We selected Apache 2.0 as license, and we released the specification of the our process and a layout rule manual. And after this, we were very lucky that we got the funding. And the funding is for PDK, for the tool development, for education, and even some Silicon area will be funded. And the funding is from the German federal BMWF, from the project which is called FMD QNC. And after we got the funding, question came up, what to provide which open source tools for designing an ASIC. And with this question in mind, we came to the idea, okay, we will make a workshop. This workshop is for PDK developers, so that we know what we have to develop. Furthermore, for tool developers, I will even go to the details, and for the designers. This was held end of June in IHP. So, basically, to design an ASIC, you need the tools. And so we invited the people who are developed and maintain the tools. For example, ngSpice, this tool was developed by Professor Holger Vogt. We invited him, then we had a talk about a Python toolkit for device modeling. Furthermore, an extension, OpenWAF. This is an extension to the ngSpice simulator to use Verilog A models. Matthias Köfferlein was presenting his tool, which is called K-Layout. Maybe this is very famous. This is a tool for take a look into GDS or modifying GDS data, generating DRC and LVS runset files for K-Layout. Even K-Layout is able to run design rule check and layout versus schematic checks. We had a talk about OpenEMS. So this is an EM simulator, PDK master, and standard cell generator for open source. IHP PDK was given by Staff Verhagen. So you implement in that case for this tool the design rules, and you can get out from the tools type of PDK and digital standard cells. And finally, we had a talk from Revolution ADA about their tool to design ASICs. To get an impression what the customers need for the tools and even for the PDK, we invited some universities, and they presented their stuff, what they like to do, to implement. And we are starting with the, I would say, simple stuff. So we had a talk about teaching digital design by open source EDL tools from Steffen Reit, Hochschule Rhein-Main. The second one is even related to the digital stuff, Iguana, end-to-end open source Linux capable RISC-V SoC in 130 nanometer CMOS technology. This might be even very famous because Thomas Benz had this talk even on the RISC-V summit in Barcelona. Then we are going to the analog part. You see even, yeah, from the analog part, that there are much more talks because our technology is better usable for analog stuff than for digital. We had a talk about teaching circuits at KIT. KIT is even a university in Germany, and this talk was given by Joachim Hebeler. Then we had some stuff about CMOS rail-to-rail operation amplifier for HPG radiation detector from Hermann Nang at Hochschule Karlsruhe. And here's the order in the talks. This is basic introduction. Here we have stuff or designs roughly 50 megahertz, what's not so high. And finally, we are for radar applications, this might be in the area from 100 gigahertz and more. Okay, so then we had a talk about ultra-low power high-density wireless biomedical sensing system from Harald Prettl, Uni Linz. Then a talk about open source design of a 24 GHz low noise amplifier, even in our technology, from Martin Sander, University of Ulm. And finally, what I said, the design flow approach for millimeter wave and sub-terahertz integrated transceiver circuits for radar and communication from Manuel Koch, V. Erlangen. So, one goal and even one result regarding the tools. In case maybe you know the design tools that are available, the commercial tools, maybe Cadence or ADS, everything is integrated together in one platform, in one suite. And for all the open source tools, it is not possible because that are all standalone tools. And what we are doing in IHP, we start with the development of a library manager so that all open source tools are combined. So you have a type of, I would say, cockpit. So you can click on a specific design. You can open the design maybe with the schematic editor or with the layout editor, similar to the stuff like this in Cadence. And our goal was even bring all together as open discussion. That was very fruitful because we get input from the designers, we get input from the tool developers. So it was a very nice discussion at this point, and I'm pretty sure that this workshop was not the last one that takes place in IHP. So even with the help of this input, we were able to give our roadmap a type of fine-tuning, and finally, the talks will be even available on YouTube soon. Currently, we are preparing the talks to put on YouTube. That's still ongoing. Some examples, some words to the flow itself. At first, to the analog flow. Clearly, we want to have a K layout oriented flow. On the right side, you see the flow that we would like to have in future. So basically, layout design is required, and we will do it via K-layout. We will offer parameterizable cells, so it means if you like to scale the NMOS transistor, the bipolar transistor, and so on, you can modify the cells as required. We need some type of physical verification, DRC, AVS, and so on. And for the simulation for schematic development, we want to use Cook's S and X scheme for simulation, and ZSPICE and XSIZE, and even for further simulation, OpenEMS. Here's an example of the Cook's S stuff. You see in the middle is a bipolar transistor surrounded by several resistors and capacitors for matching. And on the right side, you see something from the netlist. And even the directory structure of the user library, where the model for the bipolar transistor is placed, in that case here. Even for the digital stuff, we have a type of example flow. It's based on the open lane flow. I have to say it's not available yet, but we are working on this, even together with all the people that are involved in the project, for example, ETH Zurich. Our idea is to use to adapt this and to offer a type of or via a server. You can log in and maybe directly design there, or to download something from our GitHub server. So there's a prepared configuration that you can download and design your stuff. Regarding the digital design itself, to design a digital core, you need a digital standard cell library. And I'm very proud to say that in that case, we get first results from a community project. Okay, going back, SkyWater offers a digital library. We adapt this library. Unfortunately, it was not possible to use this library directly. SkyWater has even 130 nanometer technology, but we had to adapt this. And I think this library has roughly 50 cells. And during ETH Zurich, they designed their RISC-V processor. They mentioned that some digital standard cells are missing that might be very useful for implementing their RISC-V processor in our technology. And so the ETH Zurich made hackathon at two weekends, and IHP get additional input from ETH Zurich, and we implemented, or we added the cells and modified a little bit, so that finally we had 78 cells in the library. And even with this updated library, ETH Zurich made the tape out, which was done in July. And here at the bottom you see the cells that are available in this library, clear the logic function that you need, then some flip-flops, filler cells, and so on. OpenPDK project on GitHub. So, as I said, open source PDK. It is available on GitHub. What we even released at first was a roadmap as Gantt chart, then the process specification and the layout rules. We implemented kout layout layer property file and tech file. So it means if you load a GDS from IHP technology, you can see all the layers, for example, gate poly is in orange, metal one is in blue, and so on. We released HBT SPICE models, and even for MOS, our Spectrum models, for OpenEMS, tutorial scripts and documentation, primitive devices as GDS, in that case, MOS transistors, resistors, and some other examples for the MOS. That's very interesting, by the way. We get the question from contributors, can we release our measurement data for MOS and HPTs? Clearly we can do, because we made by ourselves, and so there's no reason for us to keep the measurement data secret. Yeah, for other fabs it might be not possible to get the measurement data with help of this measurement data, the models were done. In our case, it's not a problem. Then we have a basic cell set with limited set of standard cells. That was another project. This was called Open130G2. Then we have some SRAM cells as in GDS as example, and some test structures. So clearly, it's an ongoing project. We have open issues that are only some selected one. The most important point at the moment is that the models are not available in SPICE format yet, because ng-SPICE, clear the name say, requires SPICE format for simulation. Nevertheless, we are on the way to get this. The Pi cells are not usable in K layout at the moment. Even for this, we are working on, and the Rundex for design rule check and for layout versus schematic are missing at the moment. But we know all the stuff, and we are on the way to solve the issue, hopefully soon. Open issue regarding the tools. I think this is a very, very important point. At the moment, for the tools, there's a common interface missing between the tools. What finally we need, you need an output from the tool, which can be input for the next tools and so on, so that you have finally a complete chain. And that was even the reason why we started with the implementing of the Lipman as combining all tools together. And one thing that is very annoying at the moment, but maybe will be solved in the future, that there is no parasitic extraction available and even the simulation is not possible. If you have high frequency designs, then you have, for example, metal between transistors, and this metal has even a capacitance and resistance. And in case of RF design, even this minor resistance and capacitance influence your design. So you have to extract these values and you have to simulate this. And at the moment, there's no solution yet available. Some words for, I would say, advertisement. As I said, IHP has an MPW, or we have our own clean room, and so we have an MPW offer, and MPW means, in that case, multi-project wafer. So we offer this as a service for our 0.30 by CMOS technology, with frequencies that I talked about already, and for point or quarter micron EPIC technology. EPIC means, in that case, electronic and photonic components combined into one single device. And if you like to produce something in IHP, you can choose technology what you need. You have seen in the table the SG13S and G2 technology, and the technologies are stable and qualified. I think we offer the G2 technology for more than 10 years. Yeah. And we have a fixed schedule for which is 2 years in advance, and we offer at least 4 runs in 0.13 technology per year. And clearly, we offer PDKs for commercial design tools like Cadence or ADS, and with that, we have an analog and digital standard cell library available. Summary regarding this open source design kit project. It's very dynamic at the moment. Many things changes. We get additional input or requirements and requests and so on. What we are doing, we provided all required information to set up such a PDK, and we will provide any stuff what we can do. We maintain the main branch in Git. And even the first results from the community input is visible, as I talked for the project from the ETH Zurich. On IHP side, we are flexible. We got a request from customers to add spectrum models. Sure, we can add the spectrum models. Yeah, no problem. And yeah, finally, I have to say, releasing such an PDK is more than specification, and releasing the specification in the layout rule manual. Yeah, such a PDK is, that are many, many things. And finally, acknowledgement, many thanks to Sci-Fi and especially to Ruinland for supporting us. And yeah, you see there are different funded projects from the German government, especially the last one here, FMD QNC, and even special thanks to ETH Zurich and even the open source community itself. So that's all from my side. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Really interesting. My talk is actually next. I have a little bit about the SkyWater experience. Two questions that are related. One is, why did you choose K layout instead of Magic? Because Magic will do things like parameter extraction, you know, all of parasitics and all that stuff. And the second thing is, why do you think that the tool flow is sufficiently sophisticated to simply add a front end to?
Okay, at first to the question with the K-layout. We have very good experience with K-layout, and even we used in our project K-layout already. And K-layout is handled to even very large GDS files. Regarding Magic, I don't know. And even I think the support for Magic is not the same like for K-layout. We have direct contact to Matthias Köfferlein, the guy who is implementing the stuff. And it's a really amazing guy. Very good communication. If we ask the question, we will get an answer soon, and so on. I think the K-layout is a very good choice. Nevertheless, the stuff with Magic, we were thinking about to implement our PDK even in Magic. Currently, we had only one request, and so our main focus will be K-layout at the moment at first. Yeah, and the second question, can you ask this again? So maybe.
So you had said that you started with a manager at the front end to make a more commercial tool flow. My experience is that the open source tools, not only for things like digital place and route, but for timing closure and all of that, are not there yet. And so even if you put a front end on it, don't you think that there's work to do inside the tool flow before you get to that stage?
Okay, regarding the digital stuff with the timing and so on. Little bit slow, my laptop, I don't know why. That are two different things. One is the open lane flow. And for that, even, by the way, there's a tool available, I think, for timing evaluation. And for this open lane flow, we will not offer this Lipman. The Lipman is only for the analog stuff. Yeah. And the Lip Manager itself, what we offer, will be very flexible. So in background, we will have config files. So in this config file, you can say, okay, I want to open the view that is given, or a schematic. I want to open with Cooks or XGAM or whatever. Maybe you know the cadence tools, yeah? And we want to have it similar, but very, very flexible finally. Yeah, so that if you like to add a specific tool, it's on your own to do it, or we like to do this. Yeah, so we will give the freedom even to the, I would say, customer. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Further question? Yeah. Ah, sorry.
So you mentioned the parasitic extraction.
Yeah.
But I'm not very used to like this kind of software. But what is the main problem of this?
So it's the main problem.
What is the main problem of this kind of calculation?
Okay. Yeah, for the parasitic extraction. Maybe I'm going to the fourth slide. A little bit hard to see. Before you can do parasitic extraction, you have to perform the AVS, so the layout versus schematic, because in that case you get some information that you need for this parasitic extraction. Yeah, and then you know, for example, okay, here is one metal line, and it's starting from metal one, it goes up to metal two, and goes down to metal one again, and then extract the length and the width and the vias in between, and then you get, or you need some additional information from outside. The resistance of the metal is that ohm, and the via has a resistance maybe of 5 ohms, and so on, and that you have to calculate all together again. Then you have to generate a specific netlist, and the netlist consists of the transistors and even the parasitic components, like the resistance of the metal and some additional capacitance between the metals and so on. Yeah, so it's I think it's manageable, but the effort for implementation is very high. Even from my experience, the stuff with the cadence that I have, the tool flow behind, even from PDK implementation point of view, it's very difficult. It's a mess, and even we are struggling since years to offer the right working flow for parasitic extraction.
So, like Cadence, they have their own design software. They do encounter this kind of problem.
Yeah, Cadence, they have this software. This is called Quantus QRC. They have their own software, but even for the software, you have to set up your PDK. So you have to provide a specific run set, which is called QRC techfire, and in this techfire are some pre-calculated values as input for the parasitic extraction.
I have a small question about the MP-DAO. It is not related to it. And for your IHP's MP-DAO, is there any restriction for the I/O or frame data? User can use the whole area, or you provide the I/O part or something?
I assume this goes into the direction of the Google SkyWater offer. I know for Google SkyWater they have a fixed frame, and you have to fill the frame, and there is fixed frame only. In IHP you can set up your own frame. If you like to have only, I would say, 5 I/O pads, then you can do this, and you even will pay the area with the 5 I/O pads. If you need 100 pads and you have a very large design, clearly you have to pay the price for the large area, but you can use it as you like. So you have the complete freedom in IHP for designs. Yeah. Okay. So.
Okay, and I'm from university. May I know how can a university team to join the MPW? How much is it, and is there any workshop upcoming?
Okay, thank you. Yeah. Our MPW offer, we have for universities in Europe. We are part of your practice community, and you can buy your area via your practice. For universities or companies from outside Europe, we have a daughter company. This daughter company is called IHP Solution, and via that you can buy that. And even we offer workshops for our technology. It's starting with the introduction, creating simple inverter designs. Then we have an LNA example and so on. Even we are working with the Cadence, with ADS and so on. If you like, you can take a look onto our website, ihp-microelectronics.com, and even there you will find an overview about the schedule and even the price list that might be interesting for you. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.